So chapter 6 is number theory. And the real number system. Okay, so section 6.1 is number theory. So number theory is basically different types of numbers and how they work together. Okay, so A, prime numbers. Let's do a definition. If A and B are natural numbers, then we say A divides B, provided there is a natural number Q such that B equals QA. So we say A divides B. So that's what we're defining. A divides B. What do you guys think? So if A and B are natural numbers, then we say A divides B written A line B provided there is a natural number Q such that B equals QA. You guys good? Fully understand? What do you think? Does it make sense? One number divides another number if you can write that number as that number times, right? So like 3 divides 6 because I can write 6 as 2 times 3, right? So a lot of times in math, maybe all the letters can get confusing, but if you can think of an example, I think it's really helpful, right? Because this is something you completely have understood for a long time. 3 divides 6 if 6, because 6 equals 2 times 3, right? You can write 6 as something times 3. Okay? But I have a question. What the heck is a natural number? What is not a natural number? Right? What are we even talking about? So, does anybody know what a natural number is? Well, I gave you some examples, 6, 3, 2, right?
Every positive number is natural. Any positive is natural?
No. So natural numbers are the counting numbers. So how do we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Not 0, not negative numbers. The natural numbers are the counting numbers. Okay? So we're using those phrases in problems, and if you don't know what those are, you should ask, right? Don't just take it for granted.
Can you write your 3, 6
example thing out so that you know how to write them? Example. No. 3 divides 6 because, right, so 6 is B, so 6 equals Q times 3. Well, Q is clearly 2, right? because there exists a number Q, right? Provided there is a natural number Q, so there exists a Q such that this works, right? So I said it's a natural number, so I'm not having Q be a fraction. I'm having Q be a positive whole number. Okay? So Q is not 1/2. These are all whole numbers. Oh my gosh, this thermos is very good. I recommend it. Like, my mouth is still burning, and I left my house at 6:15. I think I need like an ice cube. Yes. That's why I don't answer emails after 8 o'clock. Sorry, I gotta cool it down. Got it at Target, y'all. It's a keeper. All right. So this topic is prime numbers. We all know what a prime number is, right? Well, let's write out the definition. A natural number greater than 1 is prime. So I'm defining prime, provided it's only 2 factors are 1 and itself. Okay, so here in this example, 6 equals 2 times 3. Factors of 6, these are factors, right? Okay, so a number is prime provided its only 2 factors are 1 and itself. You guys know this. Okay, so let's write out some examples. Let's write out the numbers 1 through 30 and say what's prime. Okay, so let's cross out all the non-primes. So is 2 prime?
Yes.
Because 2 is only 1 in itself, right? What about 3? Is 3 prime? The only 2 factors are 1 in itself, okay? What about 4? No, why? 2 times 2. 5? Yes, because it's only 1 in 5. 6? We already said up above, no. 7? Yes. 8? Why? 9? 10? So we can go through and cross out all the even numbers, right? Because they're all divisible by 2. So let's go and cross out the evens. Because they're all divisible by 2, right? Okay, 11, 13, 15, no, because 3 times 5, 17, no, 19, can you think of anything for 19, 21, 23, 25, 27, 29. All right, so let's circle what we have left. So these are all the primes, right? So a natural number greater than 1 is prime. So one you can only do one times itself, but one is prime, right? All right, so we kind of went through this mentally a little bit, right? So we're going to talk about divisibility tests. How do we know if something's divisible by another number? There's some tricks. So divisibility tests and factoring. Okay, so I'm going to make a big chart. So get ready for it. Number is how do you know if a number is divisible by 2? It's even. Okay. What's another way to say that? The last digit is even. The last digit is 02468.
Yeah.
The last digit is even. The last digit is divisible by 2, right? I don't care about whatever numbers are before that. If the last digit is 02468, it's divisible by 2, right? And you guys said even numbers, right? So the last digit is divisible by 2. Okay? How do you know if a number is divisible by 3? Does anybody know this one? So it's if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. So I'm going to write out the chart and we can do examples after. What if the sum of the digits are divisible by 3? A number is divisible by 4 if the last 2 digits is divisible by 4. So for 2, I only have to look at the last one to see if that's divisible by 2. For 4, I look at the last 2 to see if that's divisible by 4. How do you know if a number is divisible by 5? Good. Ends in 5 or 0. The last digit is 0 or 5. So the last digit is 0 or 5, right? Do you guys know the 6 rule? Divisible by 6. It's divisible by 6 if it is divisible by 2 and 3. So if a number is divisible by 2 and 3, it's divisible by 6 as well. There's no test for 7. Sorry to disappoint. But for 8, okay, so looking at 2, looking at 4, does anybody have a guess for 8? So look at 2, look at 4. There's a pattern. The last 3 digits, the number formed by the last 3 digits is divisible by 8. Good, so 2 was the last digit divisible by 2. 4 is the last 2. The number formed by the last 2 is divisible by 2. 8, the last 3 digits. The number formed by the last 3 digits is divisible by 8. All right, 9. The sum of the digits is divisible by 9. If the sum... And 10, how do you know if a number is divisible by 10? Last digit is 0, good. Okay, let's do an example. Determine the following. Okay. Given 13,578, determine A if it's divisible by 2. So no calculator. What do you guys think? Is this divisible by 2?
Yes,
because the last digit is divisible by 2. This is given. Gee, sorry. It's a little ugly. Sometimes my penmanship is not good. So if you guys have questions, don't be shy. Okay, so yes, and why? Because the last, because 8 is divisible by 2, right? Because the last digit is divisible by 2. Okay, is it divisible by 3? Okay, so the divisibility test for 3 says if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. So let's add them up. So 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 8 equals what? 24. Is 24 divisible by 3? What is it? 8 times 3, 24 equals 8 times 3. So the sum of the digits is divisible. Okay, I'm not spelling divisible right every time. Divisible by 3. So yes, that number is divisible by 3. So I'm going to write yes. Let's answer the question. Yes, because the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. Okay, C, is it divisible by 4? Jack, you say yes. How come? So, was it Jack that said it? I don't know. So for divisible by 4... it says if the last two digits are divisible by 4. So I'm looking at this. Is 78 equals 4 times something? Israel looks like he's saying no. Right? I'm thinking 80 is divisible by 4. Right? So 76 is divisible by 4, but 78 is not, right? No. I can't write the last two digits, right? It says if the last two digits is divisible by 4. The last two digits are 78. 78 is not divisible by 4, so no. D, is it divisible by 5? So we're looking at our original number. Is this divisible by 5? No, because the last digit is not a 0 or 5. Is it divisible by 6? Is it divisible by 6? So the divisibility test for 6 says if it's divisible by 2 and 3. We got a yes for 2. We got a yes for 3. So we get yes since it is divisible by 2 and 3. We got a no for divisible by 5. So let's do... there's no test for 6. Let's do by 8. So let's rewrite our number. We're looking at the last 3 digits. So 5, 7, 8. Can I write that as 8? Or can I write that as 8 times another number? You might need to pull out your calculator for this one, right? What'd you get, Israel? 17.25.
72.5.
Is that what you got?
72.25.
So is that a natural number? No. So no. No. Is it divisible by 9? So the question for 9 is the sum of the digits divisible by 9? Well, we already summed up the digits and we got 24. Is 24 divisible by 9? No, so the number is not divisible by 9. Right? We already said it's not divisible by 10. Okay? So those are some examples of that. I think some... I know everybody has their phone with them nowadays and has a calculator on there, but these are really helpful if you're just doing quick stuff, right? I have been known to have a huge long number on a test and ask you if it's divisible by 2, right? I'll give you guys the dollar store calculators. If you don't know the divisibility test, it might be tough, right? Is it divisible by 2? Yeah, the last digit is divisible by 2. Is it divisible by 5? Right? All right. Let's do a little stretch. You guys feel okay? You guys tired? This is all stuff you guys know, right? The divisibility test, maybe you haven't learned in a while, but... Obviously, I'm very, like, anti-calculator, right? If you haven't picked up on that. You have to be able to add and subtract, multiply and divide fractions. Here's some divisibility tests for when you don't have a calculator. So the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Every natural number what's a natural number again? What?
Every number
So the counting numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, blah, 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 blah. So every natural number greater than 1 can be written as a unique product of prime numbers. So what do we mean unique? Why are we saying unique? So 6 we can write as, what are the prime factors of 6? 2 and 3, right? That's unique because 3 times 2 is not different than 2 times 3. So it can be written in one way. 2 times 3 and 3 times 2 are the same, so you're not writing 6 in two different ways, right? Okay, example. Factor. So we have 4, 6, 2, 0. All right, so let's use those divisibility tests. All right, this is 10 times 462, right? So we're trying to write out the prime factors, so we're doing a little factor tree. Okay? So 4620, it ends in a 0, so it's divisible by 10. Okay, well, 10 is 2 times 5. What about 462? Two times. Two times what? 462. 231. Okay. I just heard 30 something. I was like, 231. Okay. Two plus 3 plus 1 is 6, so that's divisible by 3. It's 3 times what? Might need a calculator now, right? Something between 70 and 80, right? What is it? 77. Good. Right? Because 3 times 70 is 210. 3 times 80 is 240. Okay? What about 77? 7 and 11. Okay, are all of these prime? Yeah. Okay, so let's circle them and summarize. Okay. So this equals, I have 2 times 2, that's 2 squared, right? I have 1, 3, I have a 5, and I have an 11. So I've written it uniquely as a product of primes, right? 2 squared, that's 2 times 2, right? The power shows you how many times something's multiplying by itself, right? 2 cubed is 2 times 2 times 2. Maggie? Thank you. So it's always good to go back and check, right? And to check my work, too. All right, let's do another one. 600. Let's write it uniquely as a product of primes. All right, everybody's doing it on their own. I'm going to do it on my own, too. And there's different ways to get started, right? But in the end, it matters that we all get the same thing. Doesn't matter that every step is exactly the same. So again, every step doesn't have to be exactly the same, but we should be getting the same answer in the end. Did I get it right? No, it doesn't matter what order it goes in. I just go smallest to largest usually, but as long as they're all there, that's what matters, right? You could have written 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 5. I don't like to waste the ink. It's part of what I like about math. The less you write, the better, usually. All right, let's do one more. Who can help me? Wait, what? It ends in 0. It's divisible by 10.
Yeah.
All right, who can help now? We start calling on people. 2 times 5. 5 plus 4 is 9, so 54 is divisible by 9, right? 9 times 6, good. I'm just doing the divisibility test in my head sometimes, right? The last digit's a 4, so it's divisible by 2. Six is 2 times 3. 9 is 3 times 3. All right, so let's summarize that. So I like to circle all of my stuff at the bottom of the tree, right? A lot of people's mistake is maybe there's a 2 way up here and they forget it. So when I've asked this question before, it's like an organization type thing. Maybe if they did divided by 2 up here at the beginning, then sometimes they forget it. So that's why I like to go through and circle the bottom of my tree. It's just that attention to detail that sometimes is easy to forget. Good? Did I get it right? All right, so you guys can factor, yes? Kind of. All right, so let's talk about the greatest common factor. The GCD and the least common multiple. Okay, let's define these. The greatest common factor or the GCF, or sorry, greatest common divisor, I'm sorry. That's why I write an erasable pen. Because I make this. Okay. So, if people write in pen on tests, rough. There's always somewhere where it's... Nathan's like, I don't make mistakes. All right, greatest common divisor, the GCD, of 2 natural numbers. Of 2 natural numbers is the largest natural number that divides both. the largest natural number that divides both. Okay, so a natural number, again, is a counting number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. Oh my gosh, how do we find the greatest common divisor? Do we just go through and take our two numbers and then divide them by everything we can think of? Well, we just did this nice factoring thing, right? So let's use it. So to find the GCD, the greatest common divisor, we take the prime, the common, prime factors so the common prime factors between both numbers. See if we can clarify that a little bit. So that means, so we multiply the prime factors to the smallest power that appear in the prime factorization of both numbers. Okay, so let me just underline. So the smallest power that appears in the prime factorization of both numbers. That's what we're trying to look for, okay? So let's do an example. So obviously, if we're talking about prime factors, the first thing we need to do is write out the prime factorization of both numbers, right? And then we can look for the smallest power that appears in the prime factorization of both. So example number 4, GCD. So this is how it appears. It would be GCD, and then you have two numbers. So I'm looking for the GCD between these two natural numbers. So the first step is to write out the prime factorization of both numbers. We already did these two, right? 600 equals 2 cubed times 3 times 5 squared. What is 540? 5. Okay, so that's the prime factorization of each. I'm looking for the smallest power that appears in the prime factorization of both numbers. Does 2 appear in both? Mm-hmm. What's the smallest power? Squared. Does 3 appear in both? Yes. What's the smallest power that appears? 1. Right? This is 3 to the first. This is 3 to the second. So 3 to the first is the smallest power that appears. And then here I have 5 squared and 5 to the first. 5 appears in both, so 5 to the first. So this is the GCD. It's just 3 to the first, right? Which is just 3. This is 5 to the first. So 2 squared is 4. 4 times 5 is 20. 20 times 3 is 60. So the GCD is 60. And the way we did it was we wrote out the prime factorization of each, and we did the smallest power that appears in the prime factorization of both numbers. So it needs to be a prime factor in both of those numbers, both of the natural numbers, and we're writing down the smallest power that appears. All right, let's do the GCD between 20 and 24. So the first step is to write down the prime factorization of both of them. So you guys can do that. What'd you guys get for 20? Good. Now write down 24. What did you get for 24? Two cubed times three. Good. Okay, now the GCD, let me just read what I underlined again, is the smallest power that appears in the prime factorization of both numbers. So I'm looking for the prime factors that appear in both, and I'm putting that to the smallest power. So what'd you guys get? 2 squared. So I have 2 is in both. The smallest power that appears is squared. 3, not in both. 5, not in both. So this is it. Kevin, what are you not liking?
No, I'm saying I got the right piece.
I'm confused.
Are we good with this? You guys always have, I feel like all the teammates that sit together always have some stuff. Huh? I could hear you, Kevin. I don't know why. Maybe try his good ear. All right, let's do one more. 6. The GCD between the two natural numbers, 675 and 1,125. So first step is write down the prime factorization of each, right? If you need to get out your phone to use a calculator right now, I understand. But you guys should get into the habit of bringing the calculator that you're going to be able to use, right? You guys all have a calculator that has a log button, right? That's something you're going to need for the tests. So get into the habit of bringing that calculator so that you can practice with it. If you get used to practicing with your phone, you might get to a test and be like, I don't know how to do this. So find that calculator, put it in your bag. What did you guys write for 675? Somebody help me write out the factor tree. 675, I can tell that's divisible by 5, right? 5 times what?
135.
Okay, 5 is prime. 135, that's divisible by 5. 5 times what? 27. And what do you know about 27? Nine and three, and nine is three times three, right? So let me circle all my stuff, right? I go back and I find the ends of each tree to write down. Okay, and then I'm going to do 1,125. Okay, that's 5 times something. What'd you get, Maggie?
Yeah, 225.
225. 225 is divisible by 5 again. Greg, did you get 225 and it's 5 times what? Okay. If you need to pull out your phone, you can. Who can help? Let's see. Ma, what'd you get? Do you have a calculator? Okay. Who's got a calculator? Who can help? 5 times 45? And then 45 is what? 9 times 5. 9 is 3 squared, right? All right, so let's go through and circle what we have. I'm going through and circling the bottom of the trees. You'd be surprised that this is people's biggest mistake at this point, is they forget a little branch. It's the factor tree, right? Whole branch. Okay, so 675 is what? 675 is 3 to the third times 5 squared. Okay, 1125 is 3 squared times 5 cubed. All right, everybody write, so we did the factor tree, we got it together. Everybody write down the greatest common factor. If you're confused at this, go back into the notes and read what it says. I underlined it in pink. If you're not sure what you're doing, go back. I try to underline the important stuff, right? It's the factors that appear in both to the smallest power. So 3 appears in both, the smallest power is 2. 5 appears in both, the smallest power that appears is 2. Okay, so what is that number? What is it? 90? Oh, I got something different. 225? Good. All right, you guys feel good? Okay, so it's the smallest, it's the factors that appear in both raised to the smallest power. If what I wrote before isn't making sense, try to write it in your own words right now. The factors that appear in both raised to the smallest power. If that's not working for you, figure out another way to write it down.
For like this homework, are you like, do you want like the number like 225? Or can you, or you, would you be able to write it like 3 squared times 5 squared?
So you're going to have to look at how my lab wants to enter it, right?
Okay.
But if this was on a test, I think either is good. If this is a test, anything I wrote in blue is fine, right? I boxed in both before. So that's fine. Okay. All right, let's do some more. So definition... The least common multiple or LCM of two natural numbers is the smallest number that is a multiple of both. All right, so that's the definition for least common multiple. Okay, how do we find the least common multiple, right? So to find the LCM, the least common multiple, we multiply the prime factors in either. So these prime factors don't have to appear in the prime factorization of both, right? The prime factorizations in either to the highest power. So it's the prime factors in either to the highest power. All right, let's do another example. All right, so we're going to go back through. We're not, so the first part of these questions is to do the prime factorization, right? Then we do whatever the pink is. So let's, this is number 7. So least common multiple, again, I have LCM, and then in parentheses, my two numbers that I'm trying to find the least common multiple between. 600 and 540. Okay, so what was 600 as the prime factorization and 540? Somebody look back a couple of pages. Bless you. I can't hear.
2 cubed times 3 times 5 squared.
Bless you.
And 2 squared times 3 cubed times 5.
Okay, so now I'm going to go through and I'm going to look at the prime factors that appear in either to the highest power. Okay, so 2 appears, it appears in both, but what's the highest power is cubed. Bless you. Like all of a sudden there was a sudden sneeze. Something's in the air. Okay, so 3 appears in either one. It actually appears in both. The highest power that appears is cubed. 5, that happens to appear in both. The highest power that appears is squared. All right, so what is this number? It is a big number. Good. So try to find a calculator you can use for the semester and bring it to class. Next, let's do the LCM between 20 and 24. We did the prime factorization between 20 and 24. Somebody remind me? Good. Okay, so now I'm going to read the pink again. The prime factors that appear in either to the highest power. Does 2 appear in either? Yep, the highest power is 3. Does 3 appear in either? Yep, the highest power that appears is 1. Does 5 appear in either? Yep, the highest power that appears is 5. If it appears in either of them, you got to write it down. If it appears in both, you write the highest power, right? So 3 appears in either, the highest power is 1. 5 appears in either, the highest power that appears is 1. 2 appears in either, it's either 2 squared or 2 to the third, the highest power is 3, right? So what is this number? 120, yes, I agree. So you can, on a test, you can write it in either way, right? But pay attention to how MyLab wants you to enter it. If it wants you to enter it as the prime factors or if it wants you to enter it all multiplied together. Question?
So if we don't write the thing like that, the number doesn't matter on the test.
If you don't write this and you just write this, that's fine.
Okay.
All right, let's do one more. LCM between 66 and 110. Do we prime factor those yet? Nope. So that's the first step, right? So did I get the prime factorization right? Yes? Okay, so who can walk me through? Oh, we still have 2 minutes. Who can walk me through the LCM? Bless you. Okay. Who hasn't participated yet? Let's see. I think pretty much everybody has. So who can just read how to find the LCM? I'm just going back here. To find the LCM, we multiply the prime factors in either to the highest power that appears. Okay? So 2 is a prime factor. It appears in both. The highest power that appears is 1. 5 is a prime factor that appears in either one. The highest power that appears in 1 is 1. 3 is a prime factor that appears in either. 11 is. So what is this number? What is it? All right. So we're done with this section. So the homework will be assigned. I'll make it due Thursday. Because we have the other one due Tuesday. Is that correct? Okay. I'll make it due Thursday.